children of class 6th. Today I am telling you the answers of the given questions given in the previous video. Chapter 1, question number 1, define matter, name its three states with one example each. Answer 1, a thing that occupies space and has mass. Matter exists in three states, solid, substances like chair table, liquid, example water, milk, gas, example oxygen, nitrogen, steam, etc. Question 1, B part only. What is matter comprised of? Explain briefly. Answer, matter is composed of atoms. Atoms make molecules, which in turn create larger substance. As for example, every building is made of bricks, mud, cement, sand, steel and wood. Just like in the case of a building, every object is also made up of tiny particles called atoms. Question 2, A part, define liquid. Answer, a liquid, a material which has a definite volume but no definite shape and has only one free surface is called liquid. B part, explain why liquids can flow but are not compressible. Answer, liquids can flow but are not compressible because they have weak intermolecular force and intermolecular space between the molecules is more as compared to solid. Their molecules are free to change their position. Question number 3, what is gas? Question number 3, what is gas? Give two examples. A material which has neither definite shape nor definite volume is easily compressed and has no free surface is called gas. Example, you can give oxygen, nitrogen, these are the examples. B part, distinguish between solid, liquid and gas on the basis of free surface. See, like this children, you have to do solid, liquid and gas. First solid, first point, it can have any number of free surface. Liquid, it has only one free surface. Gas, it has no free surface. Question number 4, why do gases have no definite shape or volume? Answer 4, gases have no definite shape or volume because the intermolecular spaces are very large and the intermolecular forces are negligible. Question 5, find the odd one out of. Children, you have to find the odd one out of. See over here in this vacuum. Why vacuum? Answer 5, vacuum, it is not matter and others are matter. See, you can see from here, chalk, chair, stone, these all are matter. They occupy space and have mass. So, vacuum is the odd one. Now, question number 6, distinguish between the properties of a solid and liquid and a gas with respect to intermolecular forces. First point, solid, liquid, gas, like this you do it, and first has very strong intermolecular force. Liquid has less intermolecular forces as compared to solid. Gas has negligible intermolecular force. B part, intermolecular spaces. Solid has very small intermolecular spaces. Liquid has small intermolecular space which is more than the solid, and gas has very large intermolecular space. How to see part, how to contain them? Solid does not need a vessel to contain them. Liquid needs a vessel to contain them. Gas needs a vessel to contain them. D part, compressibility. Solid cannot be compressed. Liquid can be very slightly compressed and gases it can be easily compressed. E part, position of molecules with each other. Solid, position of molecules are fixed. In liquid, position of molecules are not fixed. And in gases, position of molecules are not fixed. They can move in all direction. Children, these are the answers and you have to do it in your physics notebook. Now coming to the exercise. This exercise, see, fill in the blanks given over here. Do it, fill it in your book only. No need to fill it in your notebook. Fill it, again I am saying, fill it in your book. This fill in the blanks. Then statements given below are incorrect. Whatever is incorrect, you have to underline it and you have to write the correct word. Match the column. True, false. If it is true, okay. If it is false, you have to write the correct word. Take the most appropriate answer. Thank you, children.